Logie's speech that put brain cancer on the national agenda earlier this year, Carrie Bickmore bravely spoke about her late husband's battle with the disease, highlighting the need for increased funding for brain cancer research. Each year, more than 1,500 people will be diagnosed with brain cancer, and only 20% of those diagnosed will live for 5 years or more. But there is hope with new research now underway. And to tell us more about it, we have the cure for brain cancer, well, from the Cure for Brain Cancer Foundation, Marcella Zemanek and Michelle Stewart. Guys, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. Thank you, Michelle. There is a huge global study that could see better treatments for this really horrible disease. What sets this apart from other studies in the past?
Yes, so this treatment, but there hasn't been any improvements in survival for 30 years for brain cancer, and there's been nothing new to give options for patients. So the largest global collaboration in history has now got together to do things differently, and we've created a clinical trial that is going to test treatments much faster to have options for patients.
Fantastic.
It's just such a great news because, Marcella, you've witnessed this disease, haven't you? You watched your husband, Stan, fight it.
Yes, I did. And for me, this was the most exciting. I was jumping up and down because we can't help the ones who have passed, but for the patients who are diagnosed or who are currently going through treatment, this is such a winner. And, you know, thank goodness for Brain Cancer Foundation. They've collaborated internationally and it's a huge step forward to bring, you know, treatment to patients quicker.
Oh, it's just such a good news story.
It is.
I'm thinking back to when you were, you know, looking after Stan. You struggled with your own health at the time, and not long after Stan died, you were diagnosed with breast cancer. Did you ever think that you could lose that battle?
I didn't think I could lose that battle because there has been so much research and funding put into breast cancer, and breast cancer survival rate is fantastic. Mm. And I'm one of the survivors.
There's a big difference, though, isn't there, between the mortality rates for breast cancer and brain cancer?
Huge difference, and that's what we need. We need to raise more awareness for brain cancer and receive more funding. And that's what we're all about. That's what I am really passionate about.
Now, you mentioned previously in an article that every time you see your grandchildren see a butterfly, they say, that's Stan, that's Grandpa. And I think you said you would get a butterfly tattooed on yourself somewhere. Did you do that?
I did say that, Ida, but I couldn't stand the pain.
Oh!
But the interesting thing about a butterfly is every time I go to a function for Cure Brain Cancer Foundation, butterfly appears. And
really?
It's really true. And I was just in Barrel last weekend in the gardens, and I was with two of the girls from Cure Brain Cancer Foundation, and a butterfly hovered over us, and they said, oh, we've got goosebumps. And I was at the walk on Sunday at the Manly Walk, a butterfly hovered over us.
I don't want to make this even more spookier, but I was in Mittagong last week Sunday, and that's the adjoining suburb for people who don't live in New South Wales. That's the adjoining little village next to Barrel in the Southern Highlands. And I saw a butterfly in the garden, and I thought, God, I haven't seen a butterfly in years.
But you know he always had a crush on you, so he was down there watching you.
Well, if I'd realised it was Stan, I would have said, hello, Stanley.
And Aisha is now about to show us her butterfly tattoo. Interestingly, when we heard from Carrie Bickmore at the Logies in that powerful speech she made earlier in the year, she said that brain cancer, you think it's something that's quite rare, but it isn't. It's very, very common. It's a big killer of young people in Australia, under 40, I believe.
Yes.
This trial, could we then see a cure for brain cancer, what, in 5, 10, 15 years?
Well, the reality is we don't know what's going to work, but we think this is the best chance we've ever had of actually changing the status quo. So the more treatments we can test and the faster we can test them, hopefully the faster we'll identify something that has real promise.
Amazing, amazing. Ladies, thank you so much for coming in to talk about this. And you can head to curebraincancer.org.au to find out more about this amazing trial and see how you can help. Thanks again for joining us.
Thank you.